rated M for mature.
Please tell me that I can't, that I won't, that I fail, that I'll never make it out, yeah. Please tell me all the bad, never good, fill my head full of every single doubt, yeah. Please say any negative thoughts, I pop off when I hear people say I cannot. I get off to the thought of proving everyone wrong. I won't stop to the top, so you better back off or get lost. I'ma stay loud, stay proud, never running out, never heading south. I'll be spreading out.
Welcome back, World Scholars. Welcome back to my channel. Let's get involved in an encounter. Today, I want to react to multiple TikToks that I've had stored that I was going to post in the video, but I didn't. So I'm going to react to a couple of them today, give you my thoughts on it, and hopefully educate you on women, educate you on men's standards, women's standards, and what you can look for as red flags. Without further ado, man, let's get into this, man. We're wasting time.
She rejected his proposal in front of everyone.
So, there could be a multitude of reasons for this, but I have some suspicions that go from the lowest to the highest. The lowest suspicion would say she was probably nervous and overwhelmed, and she just ran off the stage. But you can see there was some type of dialogue between them. She could be on demon time. She could be on her demon time, out there being a 304, going out on girls' trips, going to the club, meeting random guys, trying to be a boss babe, and she's just not ready for that. She needs to go through the carousel first. You know, she needs to get her chic game up. The third option, which I really believe it is, because just looking at the guy and just being able to tell what type of guy he is, she has a Chad right now digging her guts out. And many other options. Video, Instagram, and it was about a guy. He calculated, he was talking to another dude. He said, how many guys approach a girl per day? So he would put it in a calculator, and he would go through how many girls, how many men approach a girl, his girl a day. So I'll give you a sample. Let's just say 15 guys approach your girl a day, right? So you times that by 5 days, right? That's 75 men that approach a girl in a week. You times that by 4, 300 a month. You times that by 12, 3,600 men approach your girl a month. I mean, a year. Out of those 3,600, she's going to talk to at least 10% of them. She's probably going to sleep with 2% of them. That many men with that many options, she's, compared to this guy who is definitely, he's not in shape, he looks dusty, he looks like he doesn't really have a lot going for himself, and she's starting to see that, but she's using him because he might have a good job. He might give her the affection and things that she needs, but there's other things that he don't provide. He might give her that emotional, I'll be faithful to you, I'll give you that missionary, but he's out of shape, he's not doing what he needs to do. You can just tell by the way he looks. She's like a 3 or 4. She's not even passable. I wouldn't even propose to her. It has nothing to do with this situation. To me, she's just not my type of girl. So if I was that guy, like I said, get in the gym, get your investments up, get your clothes game straight, get your hair cut, make yourself look presentable. If I was him, I don't know how long ago this was, but I would definitely ditch her and focus on myself.
It's sad, and also in some way I think it's embarrassing for women that are put in those situations, because how do you make it to 40 and not learn how to get along with a man?
My nigga.
Now I'm gonna make this one brief. This is Aly Drummond. I really like Aly Drummond. She exerts principles that are more traditional and things that I she kind of resembles in a woman I want. Now I don't think that, you know, my woman wouldn't work. I would like to have her work and have her be doing something, just not sitting at home being bored. But it's not something that's going to make her more attractive to me, per se. Like, if she has a job or she has a career, that's good for her. But for me, I find her attractive for other reasons. You know, being able to bear a kid, fertile, being a mother figure, you know, being a loyal wife, not living a single life, you know, per se. Just, you know, being a loving, caring mother figure that is out of the single life and more into the home life. So that's how I see it. But I have to agree on this stance. How are you 40 years old and not able to be in a relationship? Cry on TikTok. I can't find a man. Dating sucks. I left my husband. But that's your fault. Those are decisions. You're making your life harder, your romantic life harder, because you're not, as a woman, trying to put in the effort and the work. A lot of women think men are supposed to come to them, which is true. A man is supposed to come to you. He is supposed to approach you. I feel like that's the gentleman way. You approach a woman, you let her know how you feel, you ask her out. Understandable. But to keep a man, there's certain traits that men don't like. And that's why women are single and they just don't understand it. We don't want masculine women. We don't care about your money. We don't care about your career. We don't care about your attitudes. We don't want your problems. We don't want masculine women. We want feminine women. And there should be nothing wrong with that. We can say submissive, but submissive doesn't mean you have to make the man a sandwich. Submissive is allowing your man to lead. Allowing your man to lead. Allowing your man to come to you. Hey, let's sit down and have a conversation about this, babe. What's your interpretation of this? But I make the final decision. Even though you might say something, I'm going to be like, yeah, she's right. Let me make that decision. You have to trust in your man to make the best decisions for the relationship and for the family. Your input matters, but at the end of the day, you should, if you like this man and you trust his leadership, then you should let it happen. Don't be argumentative. Be peaceful in the home, right? There's things that men look for. But also for men, you know, you gotta allow the woman to work her way into it. If you've been together for 2 months and she's not showing any of these traits, she's not working on any of these things, then you leave her. Or you leave her for the recreational zone only. But if a woman is showing these traits, don't go... I mean, it's your prerogative, but I wouldn't go out. If this woman is a 10 to me, she's a 10 to me, she's submissive in the way I explain. She's peaceful at home. She doesn't argue. She shows loyalty to me and me only. She's not all on Instagram in the DM. She's not in the club. She's not doing girls trips. She hangs out with the girls, but it's more, you know, let's go out for brunch type of thing. Let's go get a drink type of thing. And it's just her and her girls. We go on vacations together. We're doing traveling. She wants to have kids. She wants to be a mother. She wants to live a lifestyle that she can still have her freedom to work. But she understands that her responsibility is at the home. Same as me, as the man. Like, I like to go out and work, but my responsibility is at home. I'm going to take that woman serious. And all men should look at that and say, I'm going to take it serious. And show your loyalty by protecting her and providing for her and your family. So in this case, getting back to this 40-year-old woman, which is a lot of them get out of divorce thinking that they're going to find this Chad and they're going to get this successful guy and they're going to have a better life, and they end up not getting that. And it's unfortunate, but it's their fault. They got to start taking accountability. There's a lot of women that come out on TikTok and say, well, I messed up because I hopped on my marriage thinking the dating scene was going to be better. I'm going to tell you right now, 18 to 24, the study will be on the screen. 18 to 24. That's all I have to say. Cats and dogs, men, I highly suggest you invest in Chewy. The last time I checked it out, it was at $48. Get you a paycheck, no matter if you're making $15 to $1,000 an hour. Get you a paycheck, take about $100 a week, or how often you get paid, and put it into Chewy. Get your money up, guys. So it goes back to what Aly was saying. Look, she's 41, single, she ain't got no kids. And this is an unfortunate thing about women that focus solely on their career. They want to live the life like a man. There was a TikTok with, I can't think of his name, but he's from Flagrant. And he was saying there was a lot of things that he agreed with when they had the Women's March. And one of the things is, he said that women are becoming F-boys. They're becoming what they hate. And another thing Rolo Tomasi said is that women are becoming the men that they want to be, right? Unfortunately, men do not want to date men, right? So, sadly, this woman at the age 41, no kids, single, her best bet is to get a cat or a dog, chewy, any other food that's going to be best for her. And she could try to date, but I can understand that her standards will be really high and that she is not willing to drop those standards even at the ripe age of 41. Men age like wine, women age like milk. Don't let nobody tell you any differently. And this is not to hate on women. I believe there are beautiful, beautiful women in their 30s and in their 40s. Just unfortunately, men are not willing to date them. And this goes back to the studies earlier. I'm not going to repost them again. But 18 to 24. Especially if the man is a millionaire, he's making enough money, he's 6 feet tall, he has a home, he has a car, he has his life together. He's not going to want to deal with a 40-year-old woman that is on the verge of not being able to have kids, at least healthy ones. It's not saying it's impossible, but is it probable, right? He's going to deal with somebody 18 and 24 that he can kind of coach and that will be submissive and learn from him and grow with each other. So I do wish this young lady the best luck going forward, but it's the sad reality of what women are coming to now. Right, the same for men. I'm not going to just harp on women, but the same for men at a young age, especially growing up and being 30, 40, if you ain't got nothing going on in life, you ain't going to get nowhere. I'm sorry, bro. Gotta get that together.
I just think it's funny how the tables have turned. It used to be men with such high standards of what they wanted in a woman, but plot twist, these women are demanding more, no longer accepting the bare minimum, no longer accepting bottom of the barrel shit. We have standards now, and
that is not correct.
Stop it! You know how that ends.
This is a L for you, this young lady. See, man, this is the woman displayed here. This young lady is not the woman you even want to be involved with. She comes with a lot of negative connotations, and for the long term, this is not a person that you want to involve yourself with. Especially if you plan to marry this woman, have kids with this woman, and give your protection, give your life for this woman. This is not the type of woman that you take serious. This is recreational use only. She's only for recess. She's a beautiful young lady. I say she's a 7. But for me, when those words come out of her mouth, when words start to come out your mouth, it starts to take those numbers down notches, knock her down to about a 2, 2.5. Still a beautiful woman. Pretty sure she gets attention. But when women start to talk like this about standards and stuff, women do have standards and that's acceptable. But men also have standards too, and that's why young ladies like this are only used for recreational use. You know, when you play football, there's an end zone, right? What do you do when you get in the end zone? You score. What do you do after that? You kick the ball off. And basically in that scenario is you move on from her, or you just keep going to the end zone. You just keep scoring. So women do have standards, and hey, so do us men. It's not that we can't handle your standards, it's just that your standards are ridiculous, right? You want to live a lifestyle instead of finding love. men don't want to take care of you no more, especially the independent women. If you're out here yelling, you're a boss babe, I'm an independent woman, I don't need a man, then why would you need a man to take care of you and give you a certain lifestyle? It's always funny to me when a woman says, I make a lot of money and I could take care of a man and 50-50 this, but they always want a man that makes more money than them. I just never understood it, right? It just doesn't make sense. And these are these type of women. It's not all women. I've been on a little 304 tour myself. I've been slutting myself out lately. And, you know, most women just really like the way that you kind of treat them if you find the right woman, right? If you're going for a delusional woman, of course, you're going to run into those problems where you're going to have to fit some type of cycle standard, right? But if you're just, you get on these dating apps and you just find you a regular degular, most likely you're not going to have a hard time. Because their standards are not going to be crazy, especially if they're in their mid, you know, low to mid 30s, maybe even 40s. Standards are going to drop, and you're going to have an easier time. With these young women, they know they're smart, they're educated, they understand that their looks are what get them in the door. So I'm going to use my looks to get what I want, and I have these certain standards for what I want, and that's fine. But don't expect the man to take you serious. Because you come off as a gold digger. You come off as, I need a man 6 foot tall. I always say the 666 rule. Hear me out. 6 figures, 6 inches, 6 feet. Just saying, man. If this is the type of woman that you're going for, which I don't entertain these women at all. I don't even, you go on my IG, you go through my friends list. I don't have none of these. No models, nothing. Because I don't pay attention to these type of women. Because they're not something that I want in my life. I don't even want them in my life. I don't even want them around me. I don't even want to entertain them. Because I'm not entertained by their lifestyle. To a certain extent, it's kind of pathetic to me. But all in all, it's their life. I don't care. I can care less. But for the men and for the women that are looking for a relationship, this is not how you act. Well, let me get up out of here, man. That was the lesson today. I hope you young folks learned something. It's been your boy, Baylor Rhodes. And I'm out here. No, these people gonna tell you that you will never make it. Then when you do, they gonna say they knew you were going places. That's just how it works. Next thing you know, you'll be